Let me tell you something. This is what's up. You can't just read the book by the cover. No, you got to open it up and you'll discover just what God said for me and you. You got to read Jeremiah 32:40. You'll be amazed, shorty. I just want you to know he loves us so. Why, I'll never know. We're all ratchet from head to toe. I wanna say to you, all you got to do is do right by him, and your blessing will be thin. Praise the Lord, everybody. Somebody praise the Lord right now, right now. Right now, right now, right now, right now. Praise the Lord right now, right now, right now. You can read the book by the cover. Let's open it up and see what we discover. Welcome, 5 minutes or more, praising the King with King Niamo. I got my purple sash on. Purple is a relevant of royalty. I'm royalty. You're royalty. Do you know that? If you don't know who you are, but let me tell you whose you are. You are from the great I am. He got you in the palm of his hand. Now today's study is all about your face. Now there are 20 things that make up the face. Let me see if I can remember what's going on right here. You got your forehead. Now some of your foreheads is 5 heads, but God love you anyway. Okay? We got the forehead. We got our eyebrows, the eyelids, the eyeballs, the eyelids, so the upper eyelid and the bottom eyelid. You got your ears, your cheeks, your nose, your nostrils, your upper lip, your mouth, your bottom lip, and your chin. You want me to say it again? I don't think so. Because when God sees you face to face, and we all gonna meet the Lord one day, because he wanna see your face. And when he do, there's only one thing he got to say to you. Welcome, good and faithful servant. Enter into the kingdom of heaven. Or he might say, I see your face, but I don't know you. Prepare for hell and his angels. Go to the lake of fire. We don't want that. Ooh, you should be shaking in your boots right now. But we all gonna see the Lord face to face. Now remember that movie, Hellraiser? The pen man, and he had every piece of pen all over his face. He wanted his face to be seen. And when we saw it, we were shocked because he was so pinned up. But it dissected and put all the pressure points on every part of his face. The forehead, the brain, forehead, one. Then you got your eyes. From your eyes, before the eyes, it's the eyebrows. Eyebrows, eyelids, eyeballs, bottom eyelids, your ears. Then you got your nose. Then the nostrils, your lip, your mouth, then the bottom lip, and then your chin. He want to see you face to face. And when he do, oh, amazing grace. How sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. Can I get an amen up in here? All right, now. I get one. All right, can I get two? Three will do just fine. All right? Now, talking about being face to face with the Lord, every day you wake up, you can say, God, Holy Spirit, thank you for waking me up. That's the morning prayer. And may you let me go on my way. You woke me up out the bed and you woke me up in my right head. Thank you, Lord, for all you've done. I don't know how I can express it, but Lord, I thank you. for letting me stay on the run, stay in the race. And it's all because of his amazing grace. Now, when you go to bed, we say, Lord, what's that prayer? Lord, I lay me down to sleep. I pray you to you, Lord, that my soul to keep. But if I die before I wake, Lord, I pray the Lord your soul, my soul you take. Okay? So you pray those two prayers in the morning and in the night when you lay down. Now, a lot of pastors and ministers, they prepare throughout the week for a sermon on Sunday. But let me tell you something. You got a sermon every day that you get up. God is speaking and talking to you, and he wants you to deliver what he says every day. You don't got to wait till Sunday. Church is every day, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. But take one day of rest just to rejuvenate yourself. Get yourself together. Rest is good because it replenishes things that when you're on the go can't get replenished. So you have to be still. You heard of it? Just be still. Okay, so you got a sermon in you every day, in the evening and at night. All you got to do is listen. God is talking to you. He'll tell you. Okay, my heart is so heavy right now because Jeremiah's soul was on fire like Jeremiah. Jeremiah 32, 39. We're going to go to it right now. Because when I read it, it was so funny because I post this thing on my messenger. In fact, go to my messenger, go to my Facebook page, Niamo Bachelor. You can go to my YouTube channel, You're a Gospel Guy. 5 minutes or more praising him or praising the King with King Niamo. Or you can go to Bachelor One Blessed Trillionaire. I'm the first one in the family to break the curse of being broke. It's no joke. Thank you, Lord. Oh, yeah. And I want to share that with you, how you can become successful and be prosperous and never want for nothing. Okay? It all starts right here. All you got to do is think it, believe it. If you can see it, you can be it. So I got my King sash on. Oh, yeah. Coming to America. Ain't got nothing on me. Eddie Murphy, Daddy, James Earl Jones, I got you covered. You had the lion, but I got the purple sash royalty right here. Hallelujah. And let's go to Jeremiah real quick. Just real quick. Jeremiah 32, 40. We're going to start with 32, verse 32, chapter 32, 36 through 40. And now, therefore, thus saith the Lord, the God of Israel, concerning this city, wherefore ye say it shall be delivered unto the hand of the king of Babylon, by the sword, and by the famine, and by the pestilence. Behold, I will gather them out of all countries, whither I have driven them in my anger and in my fury and in great wrath. And I will bring them again unto this place, and I will cause them to dwell safely. And they shall be my people, and I will be their God. And I will give them one heart and one way, that they may fear me forever, for the good of them and of their children after them. And I will make an everlasting covenant with them, that I will not turn away from them to do them good, but I will put my fear in their hearts, that they shall not depart from me. Oh, he loves us so. I know he loved me. He loved me for years. I know he loved me. We just read it in Jeremiah 32, 36 through 40. Yes, indeed we did. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I know he loved me when he came down here. Walked 33 years. Felt the blood, sweat, and tears for me and you, my dear. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Ooh, 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 ooh. So that really touched me, that God just loves us so. Why? I'll never know. What shall I render for what God has done? What shall I render for what God has done. Oh, I give to him my heart and soul. I let him take control. I will give all to him. Oh, yeah, yeah. I will give all to him. Say it with me. Come on. What shall I render for what God has done? Yeah. What shall I render for what God has done? Oh, I give to him my heart and soul. I let him take control. I will give all to him. Oh, yeah. I will give all to him. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Now, look, he's always there for us. He loves us. Like that song, Work It Out. How you gonna pay your rent? Work it out. All your money spent. Work it out. Look, you got a light bill due. You even got a gas bill too. Your telephone disconnect. You're waiting on your next paycheck. But listen, I tell you what you ought to do. I tell you what you ought to do. Turn it over to the Lord. He work it out. Didn't he work it out? Didn't he work it out? He worked it out with no doubt. Turn it over to the Lord. He work it out. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm so glad that he loves us. I'm so glad that he's still going to always do good for us. Okay? But we can run out of goodness. And we can let God down. But in fact, we let him down all the time. Sometimes he will take his hand off of us. But if we keep that prayer and keep that scripture, Jeremiah 32, 36 through 40, we will never want for nothing. But we still got to walk right and do right and talk right. Yeah, he's not going to do that if you killing people, murdering, blasphemy, doing all kind of sinful stuff. That don't go like that. You have to be in the way of the Lord for him to protect you under his covenant, under his realm. Yes, indeed. He loves us all. But some of us, he don't like what we do. Okay? And if I'm talking to you, shout, hallelujah, hallelujah. I said, hallelujah. Said he already knew what you was going to do. And he brought you anyway. Brought you out of all your trials and tribulations. He came down here to save a nation. Walked for 33 years. And he had no sin. That's why he's the beginning and the end. And he ain't never wavered on his mighty favor. That's why he's Alpha and Omega. First and the last, he forget about your past. Never bring it up again. Like your so-called friends and family and them. Yeah, he loves us so. Why, I'll never know. We're ratchet from head to toe. Yeah. Thank you, Lord. Now, while we're here on this earth, beloved, we are all in training. Yes, indeed. God is training you and training me. This trouble you're in isn't punishment. It's training. Hebrews 12, 8. The Hebrew verb for test comes from a word that means to take a keen look at. To look. To choose. Dismiss. The notion that God does not see your struggle, on the contrary, he is fully engaged. He sees the needs of tomorrow and accordingly uses your circumstances to create the test of today. Does he not have the authority to do so? He is the potter. We are the clay. He is the shepherd. We are the sheep. He is the gardener. We are the branches. He is the teacher. We are the students. Trust his training. You'll get through this. And remember, all tests are temporary. That's what I would tell my son. He locked his keys in his house. He got a flat tire. And boy, do he blow a lid. And I keep telling him it ain't gonna last always. Like Color Purple. Heaven don't last always. You better bust Mister in the head and think about heaven later. Yeah, but it's temporary. Trust his training. They are limited in duration. The Bible says, "In all this you greatly rejoice, though now for a little while you may have had to suffer grief and all kinds of trials." 1 Peter 1, verse 6. And here's something else to keep in mind, beloved. You can't shorten your test period, but you can definitely lengthen it by being proud and stubborn, resisting what God wants to teach you. God won't deny you that choice, but neither will He protect you from the consequences of your choices. You wouldn't be that first student who had to repeat a grade in school, and you won't be the last. You can go to church on Sunday and pay lip service to God's word. You can reject the principles of truth and seek the easy way out, but it doesn't work. Good understanding gains favor, but the way of the unfaithful is hard. Proverbs 13, verse 15. Do it God's way, for that's the best way always. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Do you hear what I say? God got the best way. Do you? You can't just do you? Custom made. Ain't nobody got your shade. Nobody got your lips. We got 20 positions on our face. Did you hear what I say? Oh, yeah. Because His face is our face. And one day, we're going to see His face. And I just want to know, what do you think He's going to say to you? Welcome into the kingdom of heaven, my good and faithful servant. Or, I never knew you. Prepare for the devil and his angels. You have entered into the lake of fire. Nobody wants that. Okay? So, come the Lord's way. He's the best. He know the way. Rafiki and the Lion King, he knew the way, but he didn't know the way like God knew the way. Okay? Clap it up. Clap it up. Clap it up. Pack it up. Now stack it up. There you go. Always show love. Always care. And always try to be there. Until next time, I got my sash on, y'all. Praising Him 5 minutes or more. Praising with the King. And praise to the King with King Niamo. Until next time, I love you. But God loves you more. He has so much more in store. Neither north, either or. You better praise the Lord, your God, my Savior, your Redeemer. He's the omnipotent. Until next time, God bless.